This is Mumbai City. It is considered the financial and film capital of India. Listen to an important news from the city of Mumbai.
In a shocking incident, one person has been arrested for throwing 11 puppies in a garbage bin in Mira Road. Animal activists took the initiative to rescue the puppies. The police have arrested the supervisor under Animal Cruelty Prevention Act.
Hey, someone put dogs in a garbage bin. Incident happens in Mumbai city in India and gets arrested by police. That's also a garbage bin. But there is a man inside there. Who put that man inside that garbage bin? But why is that man inside that garbage bin? Why? Why? We are now going to a different city of India, from the western Indian city of Mumbai. We are moving to Guwahati city, in the northeastern state of Assam. Guwahati is the capital of the Indian state of Assam. It is a busy and a bustling city, largest and the most important center of the whole of the northeastern part of India. By its size, it is not as large as the other Indian metropolitan cities, like Mumbai, Delhi or Kolkata. But it is a city bearing the history, going back some thousand years. It qualifies as one of the many cities of the world with history of continuous human habitation, like cities of Varanasi and Damascus. This is the view of the archaeological excavations site in Ambari area of Guwahati. The exact location of the area of continuous human habitation in Guwahati is the locality of Uzan Bazar and its adjoining areas, including the Ambari locality. Artifacts of ancient ruins still show within the residential areas of Uzan Bazar of Guwahati city. The locality of Uzan Bazar is mainly a residential area. There is a small market with small degree of hectic activity. This bazaar or market has given its name to the entire locality. The mighty river Brahmaputra flows by Uzan Bazar. The Assamese people call this river by another name also, Luit. In spite of being part of a big city, the environment of Uzan Bazar is quiet and serene. In the quiet and green environment of the Uzan Bazar locality, thrives a large number of urban wildlife. That's a crested mynah. It is moving around on the streets. These are the twin lakes of Zorpukuri, one to the west and another to the east. Zor means a bear and Pukuri means a lake or a pond or a tank. The eastern pond is many a times covered totally or partially with floating aquatic vegetation. Number of more hens or waterfowls makes this their habitat. This is a cormorant. It's making its fishing rounds. Wow, a bittern. Egrets. This snowy egret is collecting twigs from a pine tree. These are a flock of swans. They are maintained by the adjacent Ugratara temple. Many other birds are to be seen in the Uzanmaza. That is a kite, or hawk. The bulbul is sitting on the pinnacle of the temple. Magpie robin bird is singing on the iron rods of the house. This is a dove. It is grooming itself. That is a parrot. Here is a kingfisher bird. The western of the Twin Lakes of Zorpukhuri has turtles. This is a dwarf turtle. It is rafting on a floating leaf stalk of a coconut tree. This is a larger soft-shelled turtle. It is feeding on bread pieces. Wildlife lovers visit the lake and give bread pieces to turtles and fishes. The squirrel is calling its mate. Not only the wildlife, the birds, and the animals. Some very, very free human beings are also attracted towards the locality of Uzanmaza. They are as free as the wildlife that are to be seen in this green and serene urban environment. But unlike the wildlife, they are free not by choice, but forced by the circumstances of their lives to become free of everything they had in their lives. To the lay people, they are mad people, insane, or simply vagabonds, or drifters, or homeless people. These so-called mad people are to be seen in Uzanmaza locality in a proportion far greater in comparison to other localities of the city of Guwahati. If one takes a round of the whole area of Uzanmaza, one can invariably see one or the other of these free, so-called mad people on the streets. They live their own life, in their own way, without disturbing the residents of the area. Very few incidents of any conflict between the so-called mad people and the local residents have ever been reported till date. The so-called mad people come and go. Some remain within here for varying times, some more than a year. Few of them originate in the city itself. Some come from other parts of the state of Assam. Some come here from other parts of India, as far west as the state of Punjab, and as far south as the state of Tamil Nadu. Most of them originating outside of the city drift here by the medium of the railways as ticketless travelers. The railway station of Guwahati lies at a walking distance from Uzanbazar. These are some homeless people on an overbridge of the Guwahati railway station. This person is resting on an overbridge of the Guwahati railway station. He is blind and is there on the railway station to beg. The poor homeless lady is asking for alms from the people. This is a garbage compactor machine at work. It is collecting garbage for dumping at designated garbage deposition site. To some portions of the population, the garbage bin serves as their main means of survival. These are rag pickers collecting plastic and other recyclable materials for selling. Condition of the rag picker with the vehicle is better than that of the woman. Here are some other rag pickers. These people are at the lowest rung of the society, but still they are part of the society. Many of them vote in the elections. But not all of them. For many of them, like this woman, the line dividing sanity and insanity is very thin. When the mental pressure due to extreme poverty and deprivation they are subjected to increases to a certain unbearable level, their minds snap, and they then join the bandwagon of the so-called mad homeless people. While the dog puppies in Mumbai city are put in the garbage bin by some man, this man is inside the garbage bin for his own survival. For the residents of the city, garbage bin represents the end of the journey for the household wastes. To the so-called mad homeless people from the garbage bin, start their story. Without the garbage bin, they cannot survive in the urban jungle. It provides them with food and all essentials for their degraded animal-like existence. Some people are having their lunch in a restaurant. Some on a roadside food stall. Some in their hostels. This man is having his lunch with content inside the garbage bin. Now he is collecting food for evening and night. The inhibition that a human being has for rotten and dirty things are gone in him. Humans are considered superior to animals because of the possession of the higher faculties of the brain. When the higher functions of the brain are blocked due to extreme deprivation or other causes, humans come to the same level as the animals. This man is drinking water from that muddy cesspool on the street. That same cesspool will also be used by all animals and birds to quench their thirst. Humans have evolved, humans have progressed, and humans have also retrogressed. This man is eating from inside the garbage bin. So are these crows. And so is this dog. This dog, these crows, and this man are now at the same level. Many of the persons who are mentally deranged, or turn insane, or mad, have more of medical than social causes for their condition. This man here, for example, is a permanent resident of the city of Guwahati, and has been affected by mental illness since his childhood. He roams around the city and begs from whosoever he finds, but still retaining family support for his existence. But all these so-called mad people, who are homeless and drifted to Guwahati and to Usan Bazar, are having mental derangement caused more by social causes rather than pre-existing medical diseases. These are the people who have lost everything they had in their lives, including their minds and the higher faculties of the brain. These are one portion of humanity who have slipped down the social ladder, so much so that they ceased to be part of the complex social system built by the human beings. They have dropped from the rat race of human survival. Almost all of them have, some or the other, painful experiences of their lives. To counter the pangs of mental pain, many of the faculties of the brain are shut down. As an adaptation for survival, lower function required for bare survival are kept intact, while the higher functions, which are programmed to enjoy life with all lavishness as a member of an elite society, are totally closed down by the conventional practitioners of the subject of psychiatry. They all are numbers. Yes, a number. The psychiatric standard, known as the DSM, of the American Psychiatric Association, has a number for all the mental illnesses they have known, unearthed, or classified, till now. DSM means Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders. It has a worldwide following. Given the chance, or taken to task, the psychiatrist can give a number to all the people, all the humans, of this world. Yeah, numbers for all, numbers for each and everyone. By following the DSM, or other similar standards, of classification of mental disorders. But, there is a but. A big but. Because, not all the doctors, involved in the treatment, of persons with mental problems, goes by these numbers. Unlike other streams of medical science, there is a strong difference of opinion within the field of psychiatry. The disagreement involves the very basis or concepts of psychiatry. The chasm of difference is so deep that an entity called the anti-psychiatry was born out of the fire of disagreement. Although there are differences in terms of treatment modalities within other streams of medical science, no anti-concept exists till now. So, there are no anti-medicine or anti-surgery in the manner of anti-psychiatry. Dr. Ronald David Lang was a Scottish psychiatrist who did not go by those numbers of the DSM. Although he did not like to be called a proponent of the anti-psychiatry movement, he was, however, nonetheless, one of the most vocal critic of the systems and concepts of the conventional psychiatry. Lang and many other opponents or critics of the conventional or orthodox psychiatry gave due importance on the social causes behind the mental disorders. He challenged the psychiatric diagnosis itself, arguing that the diagnosis of a mental disorder by conventional or orthodox psychiatry contradicted accepted medical procedure. He died on the 23rd of August in 1989, at the age of 61 years. Here are a few of his famous quotes on mental illness. Insanity, a perfectly rational adjustment to an insane world. Schizophrenia cannot be understood without understanding despair. The experience and behavior that gets labeled schizophrenic is a special strategy that a person invents in order to live in an unlivable situation. These are some shanties, or slums, where people of the lowest strata of the society dwell. They are to be found all over the world, some worse than these. These are poverty-stricken people, who have taken to begging. But, they are surviving by inventing ways and means for survival. Some manage to live in the shanties or the slums. Some just survive on the open streets. The demarcation dividing these people and the so-called homeless mad people who have lost their minds is very hazy. While the humanity have devised complex systems for its existence, trade and commerce have flourished.
Internal power.
So at T minus 35 seconds, the first umbilical tower has separated.
And the science have reached the outer space.
And liftoff. Liftoff of Tim Cooper, Yuri Malenchenko in 2 minutes and 6 seconds of the flight.
A portion of the same humanity are still living life, like animals. Another quote from Dr. Ronald David Lang. Whether life is worth living depends on whether there is love in life. This is the contradiction and the paradox before the humanity today. The contradiction and the paradox.
And counting the Soyuz now on internal power, and we have auto sequence start.
Two, 1, 0. ব্রহ্মাণ্ডর রহস্যর দুয়ার খুলিছাই আহা কি দেখিছো স্বপ্নাতি কি যে কল্পনাতি চিনাকি পৃথিবীখনো আকাশৰ পৰা ৰঙীন লাতুম যেন ঘূৰিছে দূৰত ৰঙীন লাতুম যেন ঘূৰিছে দূৰত
আৰু আণৱিক শক্তিক দানৱৰ পৰা আনি মানৱৰ সেৱাত লঘুৱাৰ যুগ এয়া জনাৰ যুগ এয়া বুজাৰ যুগ এয়া জেট যুগ আণৱিক যুগ এয়া কিমাৰ পৰিধি ভঙাৰ যুগ কিমাৰ পৰিধি ভঙাৰ যুগ
মানৱ দেখিছো আজি বহুত মানৱ দেখিছো আজি বহুত মানৱ
মানুহৰ দেহাতে জীয়ই কলে মলাই খাবলৈ খুদকণ নাই
মানুহৰ বিলাসী পাহৰি নাযাবা এন্ধাৰতো আছে বহুজন মল নিবাজি কেতিয়া শুনিবা ভগা জুপুৰীৰ ক্ৰন্দন ভগা জুপুৰীৰ ক্ৰন্দন
নেলাগে সমাজ নেলাগে 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 সমাজ নেলাগে নেলাগে সময় দেখুৱা ঘৰি সময় এবাৰ থমকি ৰওঁচোন আমাকে সাক্ষী কৰি নেলাগে সমাজ নেলাগে নেলাগে সময় দেখুৱা ঘূৰি